वेल, गुड आफ्टरनून क्लास एट, हाउ इज एवरीवन? वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड लीनियर इक्वेशंस। आई हैव रिसीव्ड कॉल्स फ्रॉम यू दैट सम ऑफ यू आर हैविंग सम डाउट्स। इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ क्लियरिंग योर डाउट्स, लेट मी सॉल्व सम नंबर 14 ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 2.2 फॉर यू। Let's read the question first. Lakshmi is a cashier in a bank. She has currency notes of denomination rupees 100, 50 and rupees 10 respectively. The ratio of the number of these notes is 2:3:5. The total cash with Lakshmi is rupees 4 lakh. How many notes of each denomination does she have? Let us assume that Lakshmi has got the number of 100 denomination notes equal to 2x, number of 50 denomination notes equal to 3x, and number of 10 denomination notes equal to 5x. Let's take the number of rupees 100 denomination notes to be 2x, the number of rupees 50 denomination notes to be 3x, and the number of 10 denomination notes to be 5x. Now let's calculate their value, and the value of the 100 denomination notes will come out to be 2x into 100. Similarly, the value of 50 denomination notes will come out to be 3x into 50, and the value of 10 denomination notes will come out to be 5x into 10, and total value is given here, it is 4 lakh. So the value of these three added together will be 4 lakh according to question's condition. The sum of the values of the three notes is equal to 4 lakh. So let's put them equal to 4 lakh. This is 100 into 2x. 100 into 2x plus 50 into 3x plus 10 into 5x. This total becomes 4 lakh. This will give you 200x plus 150x plus 50x is equal to 4 lakh. This will give you, see, this plus this will give you 200 plus 200, 400x is equal to 4 lakh. That means x is equal to 4 lakh upon 400. When you cancel these two zeros and 4 1ja, you will have 4 1ja 4, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. The value of x comes out to be 1000. Now this is the value of x. We have been asked the number of notes of 100 denomination. Therefore, the number of notes of rupees 100 denomination will be 2 into 1000, that is 2000. Similarly, the number of notes of rupees 50 denomination will be 3 into 1000, that is 3000, and the number of notes of rupees 10 denomination will be 5 into 1000, that will give you 5000. So this is sum number 14 for you. Let's take up sum number 15. Let's read out the sum. I have a total of rupees 3000 in coins of denomination. Mind you, in the earlier sum, they were in notes, and now we have got them in coins. The number of rupees 2 coins is 3 times the number of 5 coins. 2 coins 3 times then the number of 5 coins. That means we shall assume the number of 5 coins first. So let's start with the number of rupees 5 denomination coins be x, and the number of rupees 2 denomination in that case will be 3x, because it is 3 times, and the number of 1 denomination coins. See, we have already been told that the total number of coins is 160, and if the total number of coins is 160, if you subtract the number of 5 rupees coins and the number of 2 rupees coins from 160, you get the remaining as the 1 rupee coins. So the number of 1 rupee coins you get are 160 minus 4x. Now you have got the number of coins of each case. So let's calculate them. Now their values, when you calculate, you will multiply this with this and this with this, and of course this with this, and their total value will come out to be, the total value is rupees 300. It is given. So according to question's condition, their total value, let's calculate the first value. First is 5 into x plus 2 into 3x plus 1 into 160 minus x plus 3x is equal to, this should give you 300. Right? Are you getting me? This means 5x plus 6x plus 160 minus 4x is 300. This means, see, 5 plus 6 is 11, and if you take out 4 from 11, you get 7x. 7x plus 160 will give you 300, or you may say 7x will give you 7x will be equal to 300 minus 160, that is 140. And if 7x is equal to 140, this implies x will be 140 upon 7. That should give you the value of x. Now you have got value of x. It will be easier for you to calculate the number of coins. So the number of coins of 5 rupees denomination, 5 rupees denomination coins will be 20 because it was x, and 2 rupees denomination coins will be 3 times of it. That will be 3 into 20. So that gives you 60. And 1 rupee denomination coins will be 160 minus this 60 plus 20. That is 80 is equal to 80. So you have got 5 rupees coins, that is 20, 2 rupees coins, that is 60, and 1 rupees coins, that is 80. I hope I have made it pretty clear to you. Still, for any other doubts, you may come to me. Thanks for joining.